So all I've done is come out into the woods, and I've seen some Chinese mantis around here, and so I was like, I'm just going to watch them for a bit and watch them hunt. It's actually quite amazing. Stick around. Oh, what a week it has been for me, an expensive disaster, but we'll get to that later. And as always, some awesomeness in nature. I took a great shot of this sexy butterfly. Maybe sexy is not the right word there. I'm Koaw, and this here is Casual Outdoors Weekly, where we go over an outdoors activity for you to do every week for the benefit of your health and happiness. And we also knock up our nature smarts a bit, all under 6 minutes. As promised, I'll also announce the winning name of the baby gecko, and all of you who posted name suggestions in Koaw Nature's gecko hatching video. Check in every week. This week's outdoors activity is to watch a praying mantis hunt. There are over 2,400 species of mantids worldwide inhabiting the tropics, subtropics, and the warmer areas of the temperate zones. During the warmer months, like now in North America, you probably could find one in your garden along a path with greenery or in a nearby park. You just have to have a bit of patience and a watchful eye, as mini mantids are masters of cryptic camouflage, aka the ability to blend into their surroundings. I chose a spot near a creek in the forest because I love going into the forest and there are plenty of insects to feed the voracious appetite of any praying mantis. This little batch of plants has many prey items, including some very small frogs that are barely bigger than a US quarter. This is a great spot to find a mantis. All you have to do is find the prey and then you can find the mantis. And mantids are generalists, meaning they'll pretty much eat anything they can catch. In the Chinese mantis, I know eats pollen as well. Indeed, I found some nymphs of the invasive Chinese mantis species, easily distinguishable from other species by that yellow spot between the raptorial forearms. Nymphs are like teenagers, not fully grown, but eating and molting constantly to reach adulthood. A katydid is a juicy treat for a mantis. Some are cautious, and some are oblivious to nearby predators. This mantis is stalking its prey. Patience, slow movements, and a quick strike. This katydid never saw it coming. The clasping raptorial forearms of the mantis will hold the katydid as this predator eats every last juicy morsel. Another nearby mantis has opted to move slowly through the plants on its hunt, occasionally stopping and looking, waiting to find some prey. It spots a beetle and carefully moves towards the target. Being green, thin, and resembling the plants, this mantis blends in so well and strikes so fast. The exoskeleton of this beetle is much tougher than a katydid. That doesn't stop this mantis from eventually gnawing through the shell, consuming the still wriggling prey. This beetle takes a good 30 minutes to eat. And only a small scrap is wasted. So this activity is super chill and it's absolutely free to do. So I hope you get out there and check out some mantids hunting. A praying mantis is nifty indeed. According to current research, they are the only insect type to have stereo vision or stereopsis, which allows for the perception of depth, visualizing a 3D environment. Mantids have compound eyes with around 10,000 ommatidia, where each ommatidium contains photoreception cells as well as pigment and support cells. And if you watch a mantis hunt, you'll also notice it sways sometimes, almost like it's dancing. This movement is theorized to help it actualize depth between itself and, say, a prey item. So after shooting those mantids on a hot summer day, my camera went bust. Yes, my Nikon is dead. We'll see what those repair costs will be. And you know, it did suck, but after having my heart broken a few times, especially recently, having so many near-death experiences in my life, among other horrible things, a broken camera, though expensive, is really not that hard of an obstacle to face. And so I made a bold choice. I decided to buy an upgrade camera while that one is getting fixed because I have to shoot for Koaw Nature, which means Koaw Nature will now be shooting in 4K video. That's right, you heard me. And 4K is just higher than the standard 1080 high definition. Yeah, man, I am broke now. I'm gonna have to find like a cougar, like a wealthy cougar. Oh no, is the camera still on? Baby gecko names. Okay, let's do this. So with two votes or less, Galen M. offered the name Suzanne. All right. Barbara Z. offered Theodore, but she posted on the wrong video. And Nick M. offered, this should have won, Master Gray Gecko Dragon Pants. Yeah. and I must say, Nick, that is quite the awesome name. Sarah L. got 3 votes with the name Jeremy, but the winner was Cal L. commenting for his wife, Nancy, with the name Gorgeous.
Hey, Nancy. Congratulations on naming the new gecko Gorgeous. So, here it is. It's kind of hard to see.
Thank you, Caesar, for confirming that baby now has an official name. Suggestions for outdoors activities are always welcome for next week. I want you all to post your favorite animal down below. I'll pick a few of you and your animals, give you shout-outs, and say something cool about that animal, how it lives, its biology, etc. Spread some knowledge, be nature heroic. Thank you for watching. Cheers.